You a bitch. And then putting another man under the bus because you feel guilty. Man up, nigga. You did the crime. Man up.
Mark Breland, the ex-trainer of Deontay Wilder, revealed a lot of things in this interview. One of the things he revealed was Deontay Wilder was protected. And he said a lot of the guys on Deontay Wilder's resume, he could beat. He also revealed that Wilder did not like to train. He didn't hit the speed bag. He didn't like the jump rope. He didn't like to run. He wanted to rely on his power. He also said Wilder had a good jab when he used it. He says only one fight that he used the jab, and that was against Duvern. He also said Wilder did not like to listen. Basically, Wilder ran the training camps and did what he wanted. And I've been saying this since 2009, Wilder should be a better boxer than what he is. He's got a trainer who's a Golden Glove champion, also Olympic gold medalist champion, also a world champion. And one of the strong points of Mark Breland is his jab. Wilder has an 83-inch reach. He doesn't need to learn how to fight inside. He can use his jab. If you have a strong jab and follow by that powerful right hand, that's all Wilder really needed in the heavyweight division, standing at 6'7". But Wilder said in past interviews that he doesn't believe in the sweet science. He has power. Now, what I don't agree with, what concerns Mark Breland, is that he says Fury will beat up AJ. I don't believe that. That's a difference of opinion. And he also says Anthony Joshua does not have a jab. He just depends on power. That may have been AJ in the past, but AJ has gotten better as a boxer. He shows a strong jab against Ruiz, against Poliv. And like I said before, his boxing skills are underrated. Then he also says Deontay Wilder has a better jab than Anthony Joshua. And then he said at the age of 57 that he can beat Anthony Joshua. He would knock him out. I respect his opinion about Fury beating up Anthony Joshua and Deontay Wilder has a better jab. But you beating Anthony Joshua and knocking him out, you got knocked out by 147 pounders. At 57, how would you handle AJ's power? Obviously, like Bob Arum, Breland's a Joshua hater. He doesn't like him. I mean, Wilder doesn't train. He doesn't have any skills he developed. All he has is the power. AJ has a jab. He got boxing skills. And he continuously works in the gym every day. Breland still picks Wilder to beat Anthony Joshua, which is weird to me. Now, the response Wilder had towards Mark Breland, he says Mark Breland always been jealous of him. He said people in his camp told him to get rid of Mark Breland a long time ago, but he didn't listen because he was trying to stay loyal. In the first fight, Wilder said Breland stayed out the ring. He didn't come in the corner. He was acting like he was mad or something. I think the reason Breland was mad is because Wilder didn't follow instructions. He didn't follow the game plan. And then the second fight, he said Breland's energy was off. He didn't look right, like he knew something was going to happen. He also said, why couldn't he do the interview in the United States? Why did he have to run all the way to the UK to do the interview? He said that is more evidence to him that Breland was guilty. But meanwhile, till this day, Wilder does not have any proof that anything happened. I have to agree with Breland. Some people just can't take a loss. And Wilder is one of those people. Wilder tells Breland, my career is still going. Your career is over. It still amazes me that JD's still has a job. I will leave both interviews in the description box so you can listen to them for yourself. The latest rumor is Wilder turned down the Charles Martin fight because he wanted 8 figures. No belt, can't sell tickets, and we are in the middle of a pandemic. Anyway, leave your thoughts and comments below. Jay Beezy, subscribe to the channel. I'm gone.